Hi, this is Holly with Presence Point, and thanks for joining us today. I found myself in Ephesians 4, and if you've known much about Presence Point and shepherd leadership, you know that we love Ephesians 4:1. I urge you, Paul says, to walk in a manner worthy to what you've been called, because you've been called by God. I mean, there is no higher power, nobody higher to report ourselves to than Him, right? But I want to read to you today, this is from the English Standard Version, verses 1 through 3. I therefore, Paul says to the Ephesians, the believers in Ephesus, a prisoner of the Lord, urge you to walk in a manner worthy of the calling to which you've been called, with all humility and gentleness and patience, bearing with one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. I've spent the last couple of days with leaders from around the country talking about behavior styles. We happen to use DISC a lot, if you happen to know about DISC. Talking about situational leadership, we love the servant leadership model that Blanchard created a number of years ago. But in that process, we were called over and over again to Romans 12, to not think of ourselves more highly than we ought. And as we ended our time earlier today, we talked about living into our calling because you've been called by God. I was really drawn back to what that looked like. It looks like humility. It's hard for some of us. It's hard for me. It's not my go-to, I have to confess. And gentleness. Also, man, that is just not my go-to. It's easier for me to just be bottom line, get it done, be driven, type A, and wow, gentleness. He's calling us to gentleness with patience. Man, I'm feeling convicted the more I read this one today. Bearing with one another in love. So loving each other enough to understand, to bear with them, even to have difficult conversations with them. Because the rest of that verse says, eager, not interested in, not willing to, but eager, like anticipating, to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. And I'm just thinking how important it is for us to really maintain that spirit of unity, to be able to go maybe into a, but could be a conflict, with humility, with gentleness, with patience, with love, to deal with a problem with a brother or sister we have in Christ, or maybe a team member for a supervisor, or maybe one of our kids, adult or teenager. So today I want to just leave you with the thought that we want you to live a life worthy of your calling. We want you to live into that calling. And the reason is because you've been called by God. He's the one doing that calling. So as we finish our time today, we're going to encourage you to live into that calling by thinking a little bit about how can you be in more unity with the people in your team or in your family or in your home or your neighborhood, the people you work with, you serve with, the volunteers in your ministry. And how can you approach them to try to work through that together in humility, in patience, in gentleness, and with love? We hope that speaks somewhere to you in your life today. Thank you for joining us. And as you shepherd, we just pray that you would remember that it's the one, the God is the one we report to in that process. Blessings to you. Live into your calling this week. Bye.